I'm John Martinez from John Sporting Goods, and this demonstration is about how to hook up a crab pot properly. This crab pot that I personally use is a CTO3R Danielson pot. This is a great heavy-duty pot. It's got 10-inch wide doors, real high openings, and it's really easy for large Dungeness crab to get into this pot. If you have a crab trap with smaller doors, you're not going to catch as many crab. Another feature that I like about this particular trap is it's got two doors. One door right here for shaking the crabs back out of your pot, and one door right here if you want to reach in and get your crabs. And another thing is this bait box built in right in the center, so you can put your fish parts or your chicken right in this area. And it's nice that it's built in right there, and you can just shut everything up with one easy latch, just like that. On the bottom of my pot, I have two 2.5 pot weights. I have one on that end of the pot, and I have one on this end of the pot. They're tie strapped in there, because what's really important when this crab trap goes to the bottom is that it has stability. If this crab pot is rocking any at all, the crabs will not go into the trap. They'll know that something's wrong, and they'll be very leery of going into your pot. So you want this to go to the bottom and stay fastened down there real good. So extra weight is real important. This trap harness is real good. I like these heavy duty metal latches right here. And attached to that is 100 feet of 5/16 leaded rope. And attached to the end of the other end of the rope is a set of buoys like this. You can either use one of these buoys or you can two of these. You can't put enough buoys on any traps. What's real important when the tide's running really hard is that the rope does not pull these buoys underwater. So either use one large red and white buoy accompanied with a couple smaller buoys, and this will keep the rope on the surface. I hope this really helps you hooking up a crab pot, and good luck crabbing. If you need more information on salmon, lingcod, halibut, shrimp, and crab, consider buying my book, The Saltwater Fishing Journal for Fishing Puget Sound and the San Juan Islands.